Hey, what's up? Theric here. Let me start by saying that I wasn't even going to make this video. When I first came across one of these sock counts of, you know, male screaming at somebody, I don't know. It's the only time, first time I ever rated a video 1 star, first of all. But that was it, and I felt like, okay, I kind of want to make a video response to this person. So I started taking a look around. I saw Citizen Worm and Churn 6 and some others had to say, and pretty much they said everything I would have wanted to say, I felt like. You know, so it was like, hey, great, I don't even have to make a video. Then I started reading the comments, and so first, I guess I want to blame this video on S-Sam. It's all your fault, because you come along and you start asking these, like, rational questions and bringing a different point of view onto it, and making me question my assumptions, and now I'm having to think about it more, and I'm like, okay, well, you know what? The thing that particularly caught my eye, though, and that I wanted to comment on was this argument between Citizen Worm and S. Samp, and I guess the thing that bugged me about it is I think that it seemed like you guys were talking through each other. It's like, I don't think that your positions on this subject are really that far apart. I think one of the main things that confused the issue is this started out to be a thing about Mel and her haters, and it became about somebody else. Which is partly Citizen Worm's fault, because she sort of tried to group him into that, put him under that umbrella, and I don't think that's correct. I think, you know, as far as that goes, I'm going to attempt here to speak in the name of Synthesis, I guess. I'm going to attempt to speak for Citizen Worm and S-Samp in turn, a prospect I'm a little dubious about myself. So if I feel like I misrepresent you in anything that I say in this guise or in this mode, then please feel free to say so. But also, if you feel like, you know, I do capture what it is that you're trying to say, then please feel free to tell me that too. I'd like to know. I guess what I'd say is S-Samp. Now, you've got to know that Citizen Worm is not saying that, you know, satire and even, you know, bitching somebody out should be, you know, beyond the pale, and that, you know, everybody should have perfect immunity from anybody else ever saying anything unpleasant to them. You know, I don't think she's trying to say that at all. And Citizen Worm, I'm sure you know that S-Samp is not trying to say that anybody should be able to do whatever the hell they want with impunity, and that if someone does something that offends you, you don't have the right to say, hey, ma'am, that's not cool, I find that offensive. You know, it's kind of like the same rules have to apply to everybody. You know, if you say, well, you know, Gary brings this on to himself, you know, well, okay, that's cool, but the people that harass him bring it on themselves, bring the ridicule on themselves as well, the people who think that they're acting ridiculously. But that, once again, it's going back to being about somebody else, and I don't want to talk about that person, about Mel. Okay, now Mel tells you right up front that she ain't right, okay, you know, so having known a lot of mentally ill people and dealt with them over the years, I've seen the bad side of them, which you do see if you get to know them. It's always a little more extreme, you know, in the case of someone, but, you know, that's just something you kind of got to be prepared for if you're going to deal with somebody that lets you know right up front that they're, you know, they're kind of like, ain't right, and if you can't deal with it, then don't deal with them, you know, I mean, it's no shame to say, hey, man, I can't handle that, I'm not going to, you know, deal with them. So, yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it just has to do with the aspect of being anonymous. You know, from what I've seen, a lot of videos that are made that are, how should I put this, by YouTube users, you know, if somebody wants to make a video calling me an asshole, cussing me out or whatever, that does carry a lot more weight than, in my opinion, than somebody just bitching me out on typeboard anonymously. You know, just for that, they're willing to put their face up there that sort of gives them a little more credence. And I kind of think as a community, we all sort of recognize that. So no real problem there, nothing to be sorted. But I don't know. I think that from my point of view, all it looks like is what's being said is that, you know, Essant seems like you're saying, look, you know, we don't want to go too far with this. We don't want to become the YouTube fucking thought police and telling everybody they need to shut up because that offended somebody. And I don't think Citizen Warren is advocating that at all. You know, but I think, you know, she was expressing a lot of the anger at what people perceived, and I have to admit, I agree with, as an excessive retaliation against somebody who's, you know, ain't quite right, man. You know, you say, oh, well, you know, why do we have to treat her? Well, you don't, obviously. But at the same time, you know, we don't have to approve of that, and we don't have to say we approve. Now, as a practical matter, there's nothing anybody can really do about it. I mean, as far as people are going to post what they want, people are going to, like, remove comments or block people or delete stuff or whatever as they choose. It's their, you know, it's their channel. So the idea of being able to enforce any kind of community standard on a practical level is sort of a moot point. But I think one of the things that causes people to come together as communities is the recognition of a kind of a standard. You know, as loose as it may be, you know, I feel like there is a certain ethos that kind of bonds us all as, you know, YouTubers making videos as far as people trying to exchange ideas. But I guess that's all I gotta say about that.